Alright, so today we are in for another DIY video, but this location doesn't seem like my house. Just for a change, we've come to a different place to do this DIY, because I know doing all the DIYs in the same place would get boring. So what it's gonna be is changing the air filter on a KTM Duke 200 and the 390. The same procedure can be followed for the KTM RC 200 and the RC 390. So let's get started. Enough of me talking now, let's get the intro rolling. Alright, so the stock air filter is located below the rider seat. So you'll need to remove the rear seat using your bike's key, and you would need the 10mm T-spanner or the bit to get rid of these two screws here, which is one and two. So once that is out, the seat should be out. Okay, so once the rider seat is removed, unscrewed, you find the air filter box located right under that, and you will have to remove these two nuts what you see here, and you will need a 5-bit spanner or a T-spanner, as you can clearly see here. So let's remove this and see how the air filter looks. The last time I removed it, the air filter was damaged quite a bit, so let's see. Okay, so once both these bolts are removed, you can open the box now. Just slide it up and you can see the dirty air filter there, which is then close to about 8 to 10,000, and that's how it looks. If you can see the gaps in the front of the air filter, it's clearly worn out, so we will have to replace it with the new one, which you can see on my left here. So the new one is absolutely clean with no gaps. So all you need to do is take the new filter and put it into the box. That's about it. You can put it any side. There's no directions or there's no markings on the air filter. Just make sure it sits properly with no gaps. Okay, so once you place the air filter in the slot, you'll need to ensure that there's no gaps over here, because the new one is pretty tough to, it's pretty hard to snap it right inside. So you'll need to press it quite a bit. So it's just not that you'll have to drop it in and then close the box. You'll need to press it firmly so that there are no gaps. Okay, so once the air filter box is screwed in tightly, you'll have to make sure that the box goes in properly, because otherwise the rider seat will not close. You will find gaps over here. So as there are no gaps now, that clearly says that the air filter box has tightened up properly. So we can go ahead and now screw up the rider seat. Okay, so once the air filter change is done, you can put back the rider seat and then the pillion seat as well.
What the fuck is this?
That one, that's a secret. A review is coming very soon for most of my subscribers who have asked me. So it's still in the testing phase. I'm sure you guys know what it is. So give me some time, guys. I will let you know what it is and how it performs. So yeah, that's about it. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If you've already subscribed, enjoy the videos. If not, please do.